Fans, and welcome to Emerson Channel Sports' women's basketball broadcast. From the Bobby Brown and Stephen Plofker Gym, I'm Rico Brill, joined by the insightful Godfrey Simpri. We're gearing up for an exciting matchup between Salve Regina Seahawks and the Emerson Lions. In the recent game, Salve Regina faced a tough battle against Babson, where they fell short despite a standout performance from Sophia Neri, who led all players with 21 points and 13 rebounds. On the other side, Emerson had a challenging outing against Coast Guard Academy in their last outing, ending in a 77-50 defeat. Now, as Salve Regina looks back to bounce back against Emerson, and Emerson aims to regain their momentum, we're in for a thrilling contest tonight. Godfrey, what key factors do you think Salve Regina needs to focus on, and likewise for Emerson?
And a lot of mid-range baskets. Like, I think their main key is to play everything from inside out. If they win the inside game, they're gonna win the game. For Emerson, they need to grab offensive and defensive rebounds, and they need to be able to play good brand of basketball. They need to be able to show that they can, you know, score from the three-point line, and also, you know, grab fouls and get this team into foul trouble, because Salve is a big team. You know, they have a lot of big post players that can play in the post, and if you get them into foul trouble, it's just going to make it easier for Emerson to score.
Yeah, definitely. I think, as you noted, Salve definitely has the size advantage, and Emerson is going to have to depend on that shot, and it seems that's been the way a lot this season with Emerson. It seems like a lot of their games are decided by the three ball. For Salve, it's going to be the fifth-year player, Shuey. She's been the leader on and off the court this season for the team. She's obviously in her fifth year, so with that great veteran ability. And I look at the two Neri sisters, who, as we said, possess that great size, both standing at 6 foot, and they have been shooting well this season, getting boards and putting up good numbers.
Yeah, I think it's going to, you know, like at the end of the day, if they can score twos and get stops on defense with their size and their length and ability, I think this is going to be a very, like, very point game. And it's going to show, like, they can really play the 2-back. As you can see, both teams are 2-1 in the 2-back right now. So it's just going to show, like, whether they can play defense and score or whether Emerson can score in their own ways, which team is really going to show out. If Emerson plays fast, if Emerson plays fast and gets buckets and quality moments, they're going to be able to take them.
Yeah, and I mean, for Emerson, the story, obviously, Bree Frangelo leading the entire NUMAC in scoring with 18.5 points a game. Coupling that with 4 assists per game, she's spreading the ball out nicely and shooting well. Her field goal percentage is 48%, and her three-point percentage is 42%, which are both very respectable marks for the amount that she's shooting.
Bree is a bucket. Like, I don't even know anything else to say. Bree is a pure hooper. She does everything that she needs to from a point guard perspective. You know what I'm saying? Like, it reminds me a lot of CP3-esque, the way that she's able to spread the ball around and also gets her shots on offense. So I think, you know, if she plays her game, they're going to win this game comfortably.
Yeah, I like that comparison a lot. And for the lack of a better term, she definitely is a bucket.
She's a bucket. She's
Bree Frangelo, coming from Bryant University, last year, Emerson actually played against the Division I team where Bree Frangelo dropped her, at the time, her career high at 24 points, and I think that was enough for Emerson to get her on the team.
Yeah, I mean, when you see someone just come out and just play their game of basketball against any competition, it's really important. And I think Bree's a pure hooper, someone that's going to get their buckets against anyone. So it's going to be interesting to see what she can bring out tonight.
Now, our sideline reporter, Briggs Loveland, talked to assistant coach Jenny Rose DiCecco before the game. Here's what he has to say. Look. Looks like we're having a little trouble getting it to Briggs. We'll be with you more momentarily. As the teams have just broke their huddles and are going to the sideline to review their strategies.
Yeah, so I think another big thing that's obviously is going to be the free throw disparity. Both teams want to get to the line and create easy buckets. So I think if Emerson can get to the line and create Salve into some foul trouble, it's the one thing that's going to lead them to victory.
Like, there you go.
They need to create offensive rebounds, get stops. You know, like, the main simple things about basketball is what they're going to need to do to get this done.
And we talked about the offensive leader of this team, Bree Frangelo. The defensive leader of this team is without a doubt Charlotte Levinson, also a transfer in her third year as a junior. She missed her last season due to an injury, but coming from another D1 school, the University of Denver, she's been the heart and soul of this team defensively, and when you watch it, you will notice.
Well, I mean, when I see her play, it gives me like a defensive anchor, you know?
Yeah.
Everyone knows that everything's going to be fine inside because she's in the inside, so I think like it gives a calming effect on the guards, you know? I think that's the best thing to say about Levinson.
Yeah, and as we quiet and turn it to PA for the national anthem. As we come back from the national anthem, the two teams are lining up, and we shortly will bring you the starting lineups. Morgan Shuey leading it off. Sophia Neri. Her sister Brianna Neri, the two aforementioned big players on this team. Amanda Follin, starting at guard. And Ashley Rourke, the 5'9 forward. And those will be the five for Salve Regina. With both of the Neri sisters, Ashley Rourke, Morgan Shuey, Amanda Follin, and yes, that is the starting. Now as we introduce the Emerson starting lineup. Liv DeLaurier starting it off. Bree Frangelo. Charlotte Levinson. Ella Bushy. And the freshman Kendra Dodd starting at guard. So So, yeah, Emerson, definitely a team that's had some good freshman presence this year. Obviously, the biggest proponent of this has been number 32, Kendra Dodd. She's in the starting lineup, and she has been for most of this season.
Yes, Kendra Dodd is someone that's going to do everything for you. You know, she gets a lot of the work, a lot of the work done that's not done from Levinson and Bree. So I think she plays a vital role of, like, creating that little guard, forward, center duo.
Yeah. At that 5'8 height, she does kind of play in the middle of all those positions. And she's getting good, as we said, good time, averaging 21.4 minutes per game, which is nothing to downplay as a freshman. Here as Levinson and Neri, is Sophia Neri, will be taking the tip off. As we are underway in this game between Emerson and Salve Regina, Dodd gets the tip out to Frangelo on the perimeter. She surveys, passes it to Delaurier, back to Bushy, looks for options, passes it to Frangelo on the perimeter. Past the arc, passes it inside to, passes out to Levinson from deep, and won't go in for Levinson as they miss their first shot of the game.
It's a good possession right there. You know, you couldn't get the got an open shot, but like it wasn't, nothing really happened there.
Here is Morgan Shuey with the ball, passing it outside to Neri. Neri handles, passes it inside, and that's going to be turned over. Neri to Neri, could not come through with the connection.
Yeah, good thing that Emerson does is force good defense and create a lot of turnovers and deflections and stuff like that. So it's good for them to see that early on in the game.
Handling the ball is Frangelo once again. Surveys, and that's going to be a little chippy, but no call, says the ref. Here comes Salve Regina. Passes it inside to Neri. Looking up for the shot. Puts it up, and that's going to be blocked by Levinson with an early block in this game. Frangelo on the return with the fast break. Here is Bushy. Kendra Dodd. Inside to Levinson. Posts up. Goes under the hoop, and that's going to be a foul on Salve Regina, it appears.
It looked like the first play where Bree was driving, and we saw a lot of contact that there was no foul called. It's going to be interesting to see how these ref called the game tonight.
Looked like there was definitely some content on that Frangelo play.
A lot of contact.
As Delaurier passes it back to Frangelo. Frangelo looking for options behind the back. Passes it out. There's Dodd from three. Bang! And an early three-pointer for Emerson. That is Kendra Dodd, the freshman.
Like we said, she does a lot of the dirty work and does everything that the other two players can't do.
Here's Salve Regina passing it to Neri. Looks for options. Back to her sister, Neri. Inside. Shoots, and that's not going to bank in for Neri. Gets her own rebound. Passes it back out on the wing. There's Follin. Inside to Neri. Shoots it, and that's going to be a foul on the shot. That will be two shots for Neri.
Yeah, Salve Ray and Early just getting to their game. Their game is playing in the post, playing from the inside, and trying to get to the line.
Yeah, two stylistically different offenses so far in this game. This is Brianna Neri. She is one of two captains on this team and is a senior. Sister, as we said, also on the team. Makes the first shot.
You can already start to get the feel that like easy baskets like these from the foul line is going to be very important for this game.
Looking to make it 2 of 2 is Neri. And sinks it. Goes 2 for 2. Emerson leading 3, Salve 2. Frangelo calling out to her teammates, passing it on the wing to Dodd, looking for options. Sizes up her defender, passes it to Levinson, back to Frangelo, 4-3, and that's going to be just short as it rims out. Here.
That was a good look for her. She really liked Bree.
Absolutely. Passing it back out to the wing. Here is Rourke. And that's going to be a turnover on Salve Regina Emerson possession.
Yeah, it's fundamental basketball right there. Can't be in the lead for more than 4 seconds.
Frangelo out to Dodd, to the wing, passes it in to Bushy. To the wing, Delaurier to Frangelo, drives in. Great pass outside to Dodd, puts it up from three, and she's good once again. 2 for 2 from the freshman, Kendra playing exceptionally well from the pass from Bree Frangelo.
That was an exceptional pass from Frangelo, making the right read on the skip pass.
Salve Regina on the passes it into Neri, goes up, and that's going to be two shots again for the senior. But what can we say about Bree Frangelo? As we said, the passing ability is just incredible. As you said, CP3-like.
CP3-like for sure, incredible. Like, making the skip pass was like, it looked effortless. Like,
and the first one will can in. Looking to make it 2 of 2 once again for her fourth point of the game. And that's going to be short as Emerson gets the rebound. Emerson with the ball. Here's Frangelo. Back to Dodd again. She's heat check. And she makes it. What a shot. Kendra Dodd on absolute fire right now. As we said, it's going to be Emerson's job to sink those threes, and Kendra Dodd doing that.
It's a great start early. Three after three after three.
Here is Neri with the ball for Salve Regina. Passes it to the wing. Here's Shuli back to Neri inside. And that's going to be a travel.
That's a travel, yep.
On number 5, Sophia Neri. And some sloppy play by Salve and some really nice play by Emerson. And those shots are just falling.
Yes, I wonder if they're going to go back to Kendra right here.
I think you'd have to.
Yeah,
she's in the wing.
I think you have to.
Breeze doesn't seem to be looking away, going the other way. Here's Frangelo. And that's going to be a foul on Salve Regina on Frangelo, inbounded by Emerson. And I think you'd have to try to get Dodd the ball. She has 9 points already in this first quarter with 6 minutes left. Let's see what she can do. This is exciting. Oh, and a really errant pass by Levinson. Here is Shuey down, and she's going to put in the easy layup as Levinson with the turnover.
That was a very sloppy pass right there. Gotta be locked in on the inbound plays.
Frangelo out to Bushy. Bushy looking for options. Passes it out to Delorier. Out to Levinson. And another turnover by Levinson looking for Frangelo as Poland takes the ball. Passing it to Neri. That's a two-pointer and it's not gonna go in. Levinson looks for Delorier, passes it ahead of her. They're coming down back to Frangelo. And Dodd is open, but elects not to pass to her. Back to Frangelo. Levinson takes the ball. Bushy. And that's going to be short from Bushy. Can't really get a hand on the ball to put it where she needed to.
Very, very few sloppy plays for Levinson right now.
As that cans out for Neri. And a little bit looks like a rough rebound by Bushy. Follin looked a bit upset there. It may have been rough contact. I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah, I think there was a lot of contact there. I mean, Bushy had the positioning because she had the jump, so I think that was a good call right there from the refs.
Emerson leads 9-5 with 5 minutes and 30 seconds left in this first quarter. Passes it into Bushy. She's been silent tonight. Backs down her defender. Out to Frangelo. Barely catches it. Looks, and she's going to pick up the ball. Pass it to Delorier, who drives in. Picked up by Levinson, and that's going to be a turnover by Emerson. Everyone looked a little bit not really on the same page right there.
Yeah, it's been a few very sloppy possessions for Emerson. They need to really just calm down, and just lock into the game. Start playing it slow.
Shuey puts up the 18-footer. That's going to be no good. And rebounded by Neri and puts it in with her 6th point of the night. Playing very well.
Yeah, very much.
Apologies,
her
5th point of the night.
Using her size to her advantage.
And that's going to be Salve possession. Here comes Shuey looking up the floor, surveying. Passes it inside to Neri. Really nice pass, and she's going to make it over her defender right there. That is Sophia Neri with the 2 points.
After a very quick start from Emerson, Salve just brings it back and ties the game up.
Salvi seems to be emphasizing using their size early in this game. Here's Delorier, looks for Levinson on the perimeter. Here's Frangelo, past the arc, drives in. Passes out to wide open Delorier. And that's good again. Emerson is 4 for 4 so far in this game from 3, and they will not stop.
They need to continue shooting. If they're not going to get stops on the inside, they need to continue shooting the threes. Because at the end of the day, threes are better than twos. So.
Here is Salve passing it in. Neri to Neri. And that's going to be another 2 points for the Neri sisters. They are just putting it together, particularly Brianna Neri scoring the majority tonight. Frangela makes a nice move, gets past her defender, wide open is Dodd. She's putting it up again, and she's made it once again. 4-4-4. Kendra Dodd is unbelievable to start this game.
She's on fire. She got a takeover right now, like it's 2K right now. She's on fire.
I know what you're talking about, and this is, I mean, they just have to keep giving it her way. She looked like she was almost putting it up as a joke as Neri puts forward another 2 points. This game has been all the way between Brianna Neri and Kendra Dodd. As Frangela puts it up and one for the sophomore.
That was a beautiful scoop play.
Really
right
nice
there.
Play finishing through contact by Bree Frangela.
It will make the finish. Just scoop play. It was just beautiful. That was a beautiful layup right there.
And this is an extremely high scoring first quarter for these two teams. Emerson leading 17-13 with Frangela trying to make that 18. And she will sink it. Here is Shui looking for options. Through ball all the way in and blocked by Delorier. Really nice play right there to use her hands. And that's going to be a jump ball.
That was a beautiful block from behind right there.
Yeah, I really don't think...
Able to continue with the play and not let up the easy layup.
And it seems as Olivia Martin has checked into the game for Salve Regina. And as has Marissa Forino. Now, Liv DeLaurier with that three. She is shooting 33% on the year and has been doing a pretty good job.
Yeah, very good shooter from deep.
As Salve gets the ball and here is passing it out to Shui. And she looks for options. Here comes the screen from Neri. Drives in Shui out to the wing. Puts it up 4-3. And that's also going to be good by Ashley Rourke. So a three-point barrage early in this game. What do you say, Godfrey?
What do you say? I mean, we just missed a wide open layup right there. But as you can see, the three-point shot is what's going to lead to victory today from both teams. At least Salve is just making the right moves, get inside baskets.
As Neri right there, once again, sizing up her defender and just shooting right over her. Her size cannot be stopped right now. Using all of that 6 feet as Frangela with a nifty over the head basket layup. Really nice, pretty finish there by the sophomore. Lay.
She's really doing what she wants right now. Like, it doesn't matter. She can get to her spots.
And one thing about Frangela is she's not afraid of her size. She's only 5'3", but she's not afraid to go down, put her head down, and cook. As that is a three-pointer made by Olivia Martin. Now Salve Regina taking the lead once again from Emerson. And that's going to be Frangela making it with the left-hand finish.
Bree's just like, they can't stop her right now. Like, she's going to get her layup every single time. Like, it's very easy for her.
Or find the wide-open shooter.
Yeah.
And that's another 2 points. That's Shui that time. One of the other captains on this team and the fifth-year player. Here is Frangela once again with the ball. Looking calm and possessed. A little bit of a... pressure, slaps the ball, her defender on Bushy. Here's Dodd, passing it inside to Levinson. Levinson to the wing, to Salty, back to Frangela, and that's not going to go in. Ava Salty checking into the game. Here's Shui, waiting for her teammates to catch up. Passes it in to Neri, who's been dominating. She backs up, and that's going to be a jump ball. Really good contest
that's
by
a
Ella
really
Bushy.
Good contest, being able to contest with the ball, holding on to the ball, not letting Merrill get the shot in.
Able to get all of her hands on the ball and turn it over for Emerson possession. Emerson trailing 22-23 with 1 minute left in this first quarter of play. Here's Levinson on the three-point line, passing it to Salty. She's looking for options. Back to Levinson. Drives in.
Oh,
and an easy
that's
finish
a good
for
move.
Charlotte Levinson.
And the bump after. That's a good move. And Levinson just showing that she can play too.
Using pure brute force to put that in. Here's Shui. Passing it out. Here's Rourke. To the wing. There's Farino. Out to Shui. Out to Martin. passes it in, puts it up from 18 feet, and that's going to be good for Ashley Rourke, putting in some good work early in this game.
Yep, got the defender jumping, easy mid-range.
Here's Brangelo with 15 seconds left, drives in, and that's going to be a kicked ball violation by, I believe, Salve Regina.
This is very much an offensive-heavy game so far.
As Farina will check out for Colby Lima, number 23. And for Emerson, Claire English checking in to the game. The freshman. Miss Frangelo will shoot. Excuse me, it was not a kickball violation. It was indeed a foul. As Frangelo looking to make these points 8 and 9 in the game. And that is pure money from Frangelo. 12 seconds left for Salve. Here comes Shuey, looking for options. Dribbling the ball. Head down, screened by Neri. Puts up the jumper, and that's going to be a foul on the shot. Poor shot there from Emerson. With 3 seconds left in this quarter.
That was a bad decision to foul. I mean, she made the right decision to take the jumper with the defender behind her. With Salty behind her, it's going to cause contact, and that's an easy foul.
Morgan Shuey from Corning, Iowa, in her fifth year at Salve Regina, was the captain last year as well and played in 24 games and played very well, shot 40% from the field and 35 from three. As Emerson inbounds with 3 seconds left, here comes Frangelo. She will heave it, and that's going to be off the rim. Almost banks in for the Emerson point guard. But we will go into the break with Emerson trailing Salve Regina 26-27. Early in this game, what have you seen from these two sides, and what are the key takeaways?
I think the main thing is the three-point shooting on both sides. Both teams are making their shots. Like, both teams are hitting from deep. But the main thing is number 11, who's getting all of her points, Neri, getting all of her points from the inside. And just making all those little jumpers, jump hooks, all those type of shots. And it's looking really easy for her out on the field. Breeze making all of the correct plays on offense. It's looking, defense is coming not as much as it should be.
Yeah, I think Emerson doesn't really seem to have a solution to Brianna Neri right now. She's taller than most of their players and able to just shoot right over them with ease, as it seems. And as these two teams break their huddles, Emerson is going to have to step up. I think we have to look at Charlotte Levinson and see if they can put her on Neri and see if she can really stop her in her dominance today.
I agree. They need to really stop her from getting all those close shots. That's really what she's doing. And as we look at the highlights, we've seen Kendra Dodd, who also was good going off from three, making all of her shots from three. She's really having a good game so far, and it's going to look to see if she can continue on her hot streak so far.
Yeah, Kendra Dodd, I don't really know what to say for the freshman. Probably the best start to a game of her college career.
So far, correct.
As Shuey passes it in to Neri to start this quarter. Little aggressive, passes it outside. Back to Shuey. Shuey out to the wing. And that's going to be three from Shuey, and that's going to rim out. But they get the rebound, and that's going to be and one for Salve Regina.
Yeah.
As Olivia Martin is able to finish through the contact.
Rebounding is not coming easy for Emerson right now. They're losing all the major battles and rebounding on both sides.
Yeah, really getting killed on the boards right now is Emerson. As the senior guard shoots and misses. Rebounded by English. Here is Salty with two Frangelo. Frangelo looking down the court. Out to Salty. Out to Delorier, who puts it up from three, and that's going to be no good. Thanks for out off the backboard. Shuey with the rebound. And good hands by Ava Salty. Neri gets, and that's going to be another travel for Neri. I believe that is her second of the game.
Yeah, you can't stop and take another step, you know? It's fundamental basketball.
As Ella Bushy checks back into the game, one of the leaders, seniors on this team.
The crazy thing about Emerson is they've only missed three threes so far this game. I mean, they're actually really hot from three right now. It's going to be interesting to see whether or not they go back to it.
Levinson past the three-point line. There's Bushy. Back to Frangelo. Frangelo with a spin. And tries the unbelievable move and almost finishes. That would have been absolutely insane, Godfrey.
Yeah, a little spin layup right there. Like, she has a complete layup package. Like, a layup bag is, like, very deep for her.
Yeah, Kyrie Irving-esque.
S, very esque.
And with Frangelo, she has just been the difference for this team this year.
Yeah, the leading scorer in NUMAC, so Bucky get her.
And to just add that out of nowhere from the transfer portal, it's really nice. As she sinks the first of two, that was her 10th point, looking to make it 11 early in this game. As she's averaging 18.5, as we said earlier. And she sinks two of two. Here comes the Salve team. Shuey once again handling. Out to the corner. Back to Shuey. Inside. And that's going to be contact, but no call. And a turnover for Olivia Martin.
Yeah, that really could have went both ways. It could have been a foul call or a turnover. So the refs are really calling this really tight and letting the players play, which is good to see.
Little change of pace here with Deloria handling the ball, but back to Frangelo per usual. Passes it inside to Levinson. Sizes up her defender. She looks like she has it, and she's got it. She gets right past Mary and puts it up for the 2 points.
Yeah, she let her jump, and if you leave your feet under the paint, that's an easy layup every single time.
Or a foul call.
Yep.
Has good hands by Bushy, but she gets beat by Martin. Out to Shuley. Inside to Neri, and that's going to be another 2 points. Levinson unable to stop her right there. Here comes Frangelo. And that's going to be a foul on the shot. Two more shots coming for the leading scorer.
Yeah, like I said in the pregame, very CP3-esque. Can get to her spots at will. Literally at will, she's getting to her spots right now. She makes it look way too easy to get to her spots.
And she's just so quick with the ball in her hands. It looks like the defenders take a second to take their breath, and then the next second she's nowhere to be seen.
Yeah, she has the quick change of pace.
As Olivia Martin will check out for Salve Regina. Kendra Dodd back in the game. Eyes on her. Salve Regina trailing 31-32 with 8 minutes left in this game. Here's Shuey, passes it inside to Neri, off by a lot, rebounded by Frangelo, gets it to Bushy, back to Frangelo, and they are coming fast. Slowing it down is Frangelo through the legs, puts up a three, and misses it by quite a bit. First bad look we've seen by Frangelo all night.
Yeah, it was a good shot. It was a good shot. That's all I can say.
And that's going to be a turnover by Shuey as Neri was not looking and Bushy got the ball.
Yeah, Neri was not paying attention. I don't think she knew that the ball was in play.
Levinson inside to Bushy, sizes up her defender and gets it over. You really nice move there to beat her, even though she had a size disadvantage.
Yes, very good move to get the scoop over the outstretched hands.
Defended by Delorier. Here comes Salve Regina. Ashley Rourke passing it to Neri, back to Neri. Neri drives in. And that's going to be blocked by Bushy, once again getting her hands up there and passing it to Bree Frangelo. Here comes Frangelo up the court, looking for options. She's got Bushy. Bushy looking in, puts it up again, and she puts it in. Ella Bushy using all of her size and emphatically finishing at the rim.
That was huge, and they need a timeout. That was a huge change swing. Like, the pace of the game just changed right there.
This second quarter has been all Ella Bushy. Two back-to-back layups from a distance that were really impressive, and that block there.
Yes, I think the block was really important because the block led to points, and who knows if she doesn't get the block, what would have happened?
Yeah, Ella Bushy in her senior year. And as we will give the mic to Briggs Loveland, who talked to assistant coach Jenny Rose DeCecco before the game.
Rico, thank you so much. As talking to Coach DiCecco, she talked about the tempo. She wanted to push against the Salve Regina Seahawks, and that's what they've done so far. Now they're up by 5 points, 36-31 here in the second quarter. I also asked about Bree Frangella, how important she's been to the team. She said, quite simply, it's always nice to have someone that can score like Bree, and she gives the ball to her teammates as well. Back to you, Rico.
Thank you so much, Briggs, always for that insightful information. Here comes Salve Regina, trying to come back from this five-point deficit. Neri on the wing. Dodd on the with the defense. Hands, good hands from Dodd. Passes it inside, defended by Levinson. Neri does not bank it in. And that's going to be stolen with a poor pass by Levinson on the three, and that's going to be no good. Rebounded by Bushy. Okay, out to DeLaurier.
Really, that could have been really bad. Good thing they got the start.
Yeah, Emerson needs to tighten up those loose ends as DeLaurier looks for options and gets a screen by Bushy. Levinson out to Dodd. Back to Levinson and puts it up. Really nice feed by the freshman Kendra Dodd to Charlotte Levinson.
Yeah, Kendra Dodd making all the plays. She's making a lot of plays tonight.
Looking like she's going to be the next leader of this team when her time comes.
Yes.
Here is Salve into Neri. And just not able to defend her is Bushy despite the good effort. And that's going to be another 2 points for Neri, who already has 13 on the night. That is Brianna Neri. As DeLaurier from three, no good. Banks out. Here's Shuey for Salve Regina. Defended by the freshman Dodd. Back to Neri once again. Defended by Bushy. Puts it up. Neri, no good. Rattles out. Cannot can in. Here is Frangelo back to DeLaurier.
If you saw on the last possession, Levinson did come up for the...
And Bushy puts it in again.
That was a beautiful layup. But as I was saying, Levinson came for the help double, but it was a fake help double. So it's going to be interesting how they're playing Neri from now on for the rest of the game.
And there's Neri again, scoring her 15th point on the night. Absolute dominance, and Emerson's going to have to change their game plan up for her. As Frangelo goes under the rim, looks for Dodd, who puts it again. Oh. And her first miss of the night, the heat check finally runs out. But Kendra Dodd, what a beginning to this night, nonetheless.
Amazing start.
And that's going to be stolen by Dodd. Looking for options, being patient. As she gives it to Frangelo, poor pass by Dodd, but Emerson retains the possession.
Yeah, that was a smart pass, but at least they keep the ball back down.
As Taylor Arnold will come in the game, another freshman for Emerson. Had a underrated impact on this team this year as she can get some good plays going for this Emerson side.
Yes, very much one of the few spark plugs on this team that can make plays.
As Frangelo sinks it from deep with ease. Bree Frangelo, an incredible three-point shooter, adds to Emerson's success tonight. Here is Neri once again, and that's going to hit the side of the boards. Rebounded by Frangelo on the fast break. She's coming in fast. And a nice hero step by Frangelo, and it's not able to go in as she runs back. Doesn't realize that Emerson had the ball, and she wanted that badly. That would have been pretty.
That would have been beautiful. I mean, she had the defender going one way. She just couldn't convert on the layup. It was almost going to be a beautiful move right there.
It makes you think, coming from a D1 program to a Division III program, you have a little freedom to have a little fun like that.
Yes, of course. And basketball is the game of fun, so.
Of course. As Salty shoots from three and just can't get it in. As here comes Salve coming in hard. Ashley Rourke with the ball. Passes it to Shuey. Out to the wing. And that's Martin. And that's going to be good from three. Olivia Martin, the senior guard, able to sink it.
That was their first three for the whole quarter. It seems like they got away from it. And they were making their threes earlier in the game.
Two teams between Salve and Emerson who historically aren't great three-point shooters this season, but doing it very well. Here's Arnold backing up her defender and almost able to back it up, and that's going to be a foul on Arnold. But good attempt there to back down her defender.
Yes, but also got to play defense without fouling.
I agree. Salty, the vocal leader of this team in the clubhouse, using her voice early in this game.
Yeah, Salty's very much a do-it-all guard.
And that's going to be a turnover for Salve.
Another travel. I think that's their fourth.
And a technical foul on Charlotte Levinson. So, yeah, it's an offensive foul on Neri and a technical foul on Charlotte Levinson. seems like maybe a little bit of expletives at the end of that play.
Yep. I mean, it's a good matchup. Levison and Mary, like, it's a good matchup. And, of course, you know, they're going to play each other hard. It's just the most important thing is just to continue to be locked in and not cost the team.
Yeah, and here comes Rihanna Neri shooting her first, and she sinks it. Brianna Neri averaging 14.5 points per game as a center and 7 rebounds. Very good contributions for this team. One of the true leaders. She is the senior.
Yeah, she just controls the paint. Like, you always need that big that could just do it all, get baskets, get rebounds, get assists, can pass out, and she just does that and more.
And with her and her sister playing for most of the game, it seems like they really have that next level connection.
Yes.
Ashui passes it in once again, Neri, and she's fouled on the shot. Two more free throws for Neri. It seems like I'm a broken record player, but I'm not. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it seems like that technical really changed a lot. Like, that's honestly, it's a 4-point swing because they got the ball right back.
As Taylor Arnold will check out for her sister, Elise Arnold. We have two sets of sisters in this game. Makes the first one up to 18 points on the night.
Yeah, main thing is playing defense without fouling. It feels like we've seen her at the charity strike a lot this game.
And I think they're going to keep giving it to her way because there's something special brewing here. We have 3 minutes left in the first half. She's already at 19 points.
Yeah, you could see a 40 ball. Who knows?
This almost never happens in the new MAC, let alone like D3 women's basketball. This would be very exciting.
Yes, yes. Collegiate basketball, you never see people go for 40. It's more very much team-oriented.
Here's Salty. Passing it to DeLaurier. Senior to senior. Back to Frangelo. Takes a dribble out to Arnold, puts it up for a three, and cannot bank it in.
They're becoming ice cold from the three-point line right now.
Yeah, ever since that beginning. Out to Neri, and that's going to be a travel on Neri. I think that's her third travel of the game.
That's her third travel, and I think it's like the fifth travel the whole game.
She really has to get those feet set. If she keeps doing this, she's going to cost her team the game.
Yes. You see, what I like to see is I like to see Levinson get back in the game. I think you gotta let your players play with that passion. You know what I mean?
I agree. Discipline is essential, but at the same time, Levinson's fieriness is what leads this team and is such a big part of their identity. As we see, Kaylin O'Mara, the freshman, check in number 30. Salty drives in, looks inside for O'Mara, and that's gonna be a turnover by O'Mara, the freshman.
Yeah, I think she just didn't handle the ball well. She just dropped it.
Yeah, maybe a bit of nerves just checking into the game for the first time.
Yep.
As Shuey dribbles the ball up the court, guarded by Salty, a defensive presence. Out to, here is Salva Regina, and Frangelo hits the floor, and that's gonna be an offensive flower on Neri again. Another turnover by Neri. As Deanna Linscott enters the game, or will enter the game, for the aforementioned Sophia Neri, who's been having a little bit of struggles this game. Here's DeLaurier with the ball.
These last 2 minutes are going to be crucial for this game.
Yeah, we'll see how these teams close out this half. Tie game 42-42 with 2 minutes left in the game. O'Mara passes it to the wing. Here comes DeLaurier. She puts it up, and that's going to be no call. Little bit of contact there.
Not a little bit, a lot of bit of contact.
You tell him, Godfrey, but nonetheless, no call. Here is Salve out to Shui. Inside to Neri, passes it out. That's going to be a three, and good again. Olivia Martin, her third three of the game. She's been unbelievable from beyond the arc.
Yeah, they're playing unconventional to their stats. They're making the threes this game.
As O'Mara looks, fakes the look, passes to Frangelo, back to Bushy. 1 minute left in this contest in the first half, and that's going to be a bad pass by Bushy and a turnover.
Yeah, the momentum is changing, and the momentum is changing fast. And just like that, Levison's back in the game.
Yeah, good observation. Levinson coming back in the game for O'Mara. Looks like she served her punishment for that technical foul.
Yes. Number 35, Martin. 3 for 3 from three. Has not missed a shot today.
Yeah, she's been really good. Really good. And that's going to be no foul, but another 2 points as she is at 21 points in the first half for Brianna Neri, the freshman, the senior, as Frangelo goes in, and that's going to be a foul on the floor. Frangelo consistently drawing those fouls.
Yes, consistently. I can't say it enough. Whenever Emerson needs a basket or needs anything, basically, they just go to Bri and let her cook.
As you said, let her cook. And I think that's what the motto of this team has been this season. When you get such a good addition, you just have to put everything, all your eggs in one basket and let her carry this team.
Yes.
As she hits her first one. Frangelo up to 16 points. So we have a two-headed scoring battle between Frangelo and Neri that is really interesting to watch.
Yes, and then also with players like Martin and Dodd having their own respective good games as well.
Yeah. Frangelo up to 17 points. As Shui drives the ball with a minute left in this under a minute left. Out to the wing, shoots from three, and that's going to be no good. Rebounded by DeLaurier on the fast break. Traffic for Emerson as Frangelo puts in the easy layup with her left hand. She's at 19 points on the night.
Makes it look easy.
And on the other end, here comes Salve quickly. On the wing is Lynn Scott. Out to Shui. She's open but doesn't shoot. Inside, and that's going to be Martin. No good for her first miss of the night. Olivia Martin not able to put in the layup.
Yes, that would have been huge, but to be able to get the turnover and change sides and hold it for the last basket, it'd be a game changer for this half.
And I just have to say, if you're not watching this game, turn it on. We have a scoring battle. 46-47, 10 seconds left. Here is the captain, Bri Frangelo, with the ball. Passes out to DeLaurier, puts it up from three, and just comes up short, rebounded by Salve. 1 second left, and they're going to dribble it out. That was Fullen dribbling it out into the halftime. So, Emerson, 46, Sava Regina, 47. What a great first half, an offensive battle, and a really entertaining game.
Yeah, we're getting buckets. We're getting pure hoops. We're getting pure inside basketball from both sides. Like, Neri is cooking right now on offense for the mid-range level. And Frangulo is just playing basketball. She's playing her game. Like, I continue to say and harp on the fact that she plays CP3S basketball. And for anyone that doesn't understand what I mean by that, is CP3 is able to control the game by themselves, which Bri does the same exact thing.
I know. Bri Frangelo has 19 points. She's shooting 50% from the field, and she just puts her head down, and she drives in, and it always works out for Emerson.
Yes, it's either she's getting the layup or she's getting fouled, and that's 2 free points for her at the line.
Frangelo also with 7 assists in the first half, which is incredible, to only 1 turnover. You cannot get more efficient than that, passing and handling the ball. She is a point guard in every single sense of the word.
Every single sense of the word. I agree so much. And from the Salve side of things, Neri is cooking. Like, I don't think there's anything else I can say. Neri is cooking, absolutely getting to her spots. Martin is playing good basketball too. I think as much as we're talking about Neri and Frangulo, I think we need to talk about Martin and Dodd, because they're both having great games as well. And it's going to be interesting. It's going to be the biggest thing is whether Dodd and Martin are able to continue their scoring into the next half.
Especially since Dodd and Martin are the third and fourth options, fifth options on their teams. It'll be interesting if the teams notice that these players have the hot hand and try to keep getting into them, or just try to play their game and not focus on that.
I think
Salve has done a really good job using their bodies, using their size, getting the boards. Emerson really needs to work on that. But their biggest kryptonite has been the other Neri sister, with she already has 6 turnovers in this game.
She's traveling. Like, it's the only thing I can say. Like, she's just traveling too much with the ball, and she's not making the correct plays, really hurting her team right now. Hopefully in the second half she plays better and understands, like, this is a big game. Obviously, every single game in a new MAC is a big game. So she needs to do her part and to lead her team to a W. And also, I think the next thing that Salve needs to do is continue shooting the three ball. They're actually shooting at a high clip right now. They're 4-for-7, 57%. They're making the shots. They need to continue shooting. I understand. If they can play inside out, like I was saying, they have a pretty good chance to win this game. But for Emerson, in my opinion, they need to start getting some to the free throw line. They haven't missed a free throw yet. They're 9-for-9. If they can get to the free throw line, create easy baskets for themselves, and continue to hit their shots, they have a great chance of winning as well.
Thank you for tuning in to First Half Action. We'll be right back after the break with second half action between Salve Regina and Emerson. Thank you. Thank you.
Head coach Bill Gold talked with his assistant coaches along with senior Ella Bushy, and they talked about the – I'm on. All right. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, we on, baby. I left my notes. Other coaches, they talked about communication. They said that communicating on offense and defense was the big priority here in this second half. Be on the lookout for that, guys. Back to you.
Superstar, villain like a pop star.
don't hear me? You don't hear me? Should I go on the headset? Headset? Should I go on the headset? Alright, they can't hear me.
Welcome back to the Bobby Brown and Stephen Plofker Gym for second half action. Here I will give it to Briggs Loveland for some information.
Hey, thanks, Rico. I heard a little bit of the conversation between Bill Gold and his assistant coaches. They talked a lot about the communication here in the second half. Communication is going to be huge. It's a very close game, down by one. It's going to be exciting second half, but they have to communicate not only on the defensive side, but on the offensive side as well. A lot of open looks, but no one seems to be getting the pass, the ball, to the open looks. Back to you, Rico.
Thank you. As Laurier puts it up from three, and that will not be good. Rebounded by Neri. Thank you, Briggs, as always. Inside, good pass by Shuey. Inside, there's Neri, and she's going to score. Good start to the half by Sophia Neri, who had a bit of a rough first half, looking to bounce back. As Frangela will put it up from deep, and she will not sink it as that bounces out. But Ella Bushy with the rebound. Here's Kendra Dodd. And they will start over. Bree Frangela. Yelling instructions out to Delorier. And that's going to be a double dribble. Yep. Little bit of a mental lapse there by Liv Delorier.
Yeah, got to lock in. It's getting closer and closer to crunch time. So we got to lock in. And
a game decided by one score, you can't be doing that.
Yeah.
Here comes Salve. Out to Follin, and that's going to be defended by Frangelo. Inside is Sophia Neri. She's going to put it up with her left hand. That's going to be no good. Rebounded by her sister. And that's going to be a score for Brianna Neri, who is now up to 23 points, which is two away from her season high. And that's going to be a turnover for Emerson, as that is an offensive foul on Bree Frangelo. So that's going to be her second turnover of the game.
Yeah, just starting off slow. Just continue off slow after half.
Here's Sophia Neri. Out to Chewy. Back to Neri. It to her sister. Passes, shoots it up, and that's going to be no good. Rebounded by herself. And one for Brianna Neri, who has now officially tied her season high in points at 25. This is just the start of the second half. She's looking to break it on the shot.
She's going to have 30-plus. And Emerson, I thought, you would make defensive changes after half. There hasn't been a lot of defensive changes after half, I'm not going to lie.
And if you're not able to stop her, you can't be fouling.
Yeah, you can't foul. You can't give another extra point at the line. If you give up two, you give up two.
As she is now up to 26 points. Here's Frangelo, the other scoring leader for Emerson. Passes it out to Dodd. She's going to put it up 4-3. And that sinks again for Kendra Dodd. She has been pure tonight, to say the least. 4-for-5 on the three-point shot.
Yeah, another big shot. And it keeps the game within reach.
Here's Neri. Puts it up. Gets her own rebound. Pushes down Bushy. And Bushy's just not able to contest. Neri dominating tonight. That's her 28th point, and another and one.
She's going, like, every time she scores, it's the same thing. It's just her using her force and just getting extra points. It's really simple. Her game is really simple. All she's doing is getting to her post, getting to her spots, and just getting the easy layup.
And Kendra Dodd coming out of both halves, starting incredibly hot. We'll see if they keep giving it to her as she hits her 29th point. For Brianna Neri. Let's see how many she gets. I think 40 is definitely in question. 50 maybe. Here's Frangela driving in. And she's going to try to use some jelly on that shot, but can't finish. Tried to spin it in. And there's Shuey passing it in to the wing. Passes it to Neri. Guarded really tightly by English as Shuey gets the ball back on the perimeter. There is the shot from three, and that's going to be no good. Rebounded by Levinson, and a foul by Neri.
I think at this point, you double Neri. I think so. Like, you got to get the ball out.
Make someone else make the play, right?
You got to make someone else score. Like,
they did right there. Ashley Rourke not able to make the shot. You got to just stop her. Like, she can't be doing this. Same thing on the other side. They need to be stopping Frangelo and Dodd as Delorier fakes the shot, gets her a jump, and that's going to be two shots for Liv Delorier.
Yeah, that's a great call. She swiped out her arm. It's a good call right there.
Yeah. Definitely stop the shooting motion for Liv Delorier. Liv Delorier, a senior out of West Hartford, Connecticut, as she makes her first of two free throws.
That's a lucky roll to go.
Fun fact about Liv Delorier, she's actually fluent in ASL and won an Excellence in ASL Award, American Sign Language, as she makes her second. As Emerson takes a timeout, and we, after this first timeout, we're going to hand it to Briggs Loveland, who's going to give us some insight. He'll be with us shortly. So far in the start of this half, I think the main three players have been Dodd, Frangelo, and Neri.
Yeah, I mean, it's the same three players that we were talking about in the first half. Nothing really has changed. You thought, you know, coming off of the halftime, you know, there'd be some changes made on defense. It doesn't look like we've seen any changes, to be honest. Like, I think at some point you got to make some decisions on who you're going to let score. You know, if I'm Emerson, I'm not letting Nira touch the ball. I'm not letting her get easy points like she has the whole game.
And for Kendra Dodd, she's been shooting 30% and amazing today as we panned it to Briggs for some sideline information.
Thank you, Rico. During the timeout, head coach Bill Gold told his team they're playing too much one-on-one basketball. They're worried about everything else around them instead of focusing on team basketball. They need to lock in together as one unit. That's going to help them do better in this second half. Rico, back to you.
Thanks, Briggs. Yeah, that's interesting to hear. Coach Gould emphasizing the team aspect of this game. As we were just talking about, it seems like it's been three players the whole game. We need to see more of everyone involved.
Basketball's the ultimate team sport. If we're not seeing everyone get involved, like, what are you doing?
As Rourke sinks the 18-footer, bounces in with a little bit of an awkward bounce, but gets in nonetheless. Here's Frangelo to Delorier. Delorier holds the ball back to English. And that's going to be a turnover. And here comes Salve. Shuey leading the team. Passes it to the wing. That is Fullen. Back to Shuey. Inside to Sophia Neri, not able to have her shot roll in.
Yeah, it's not her game tonight. She's not having a good game.
As Frangelo puts it up from three and sinks it once again. Bree Frangelo now up to 22 points in this game. What can you say?
Yeah, I mean, transition, Hezzy pull, three, like that's a good take right there.
She just has such a pure shot and just gets it up so quickly. I think the quickness of her shot is what makes her so good. As here is Salve with the ball. That's going to be a two-pointer put up and drained by Amanda Follin.
That's a great response.
Amanda Follin, one of the leaders on this team, a senior, and I'd like to see her get a little bit more involved. Inside to English, back down her defender, Neri, and can't get it in. But nice attempt with the post up. Good defense there by Sophia Neri. Here is Follin passing it to Shuey. Here's Shuey. Inside to Neri, and that's going to be a travel. Another travel.
Another travel. I think that's the eighth one.
This time by Brianna Neri.
Yeah, it's another travel. I mean, it's been like, boy, eighth, ninth travel this game. I don't think there's much to say. Another lousy pass.
Both of these teams need to tighten things up early in this half. It's a lot of sloppy play.
Yeah, it started out really well. It's just like, as the game has kind of worn on, you see more sloppy basketball.
Here's Shuey guarded by Dodd. Good pass right there, but not able to finish. Looks like there was some contact, and that's going to be a jump ball. Good defense right there. But a really nice, really good look from Shuey, just not able to finish it, was Rourke.
getting the looks that they want. I mean, honestly, Salve is getting everything that they want right now pretty easily, except for now when they get a stop.
Really good steal right there by Charlotte Levinson. She's been a little quiet defensively. Like to see her get some more impact. Here's Frangelo out to Levinson. And that's going to be deflected by Neri. Past Rourke. Here comes Rourke with the ball. Back to Shuey.
I wonder if that tech earlier on Levinson has affected her game in many ways. As she gets a steal right on
cue. Charlotte Levinson with two steals on back-to-back possessions for Salve. Really nice handle by Frangelo, looking for options. Passes it inside to English, back out to Frangelo, and that's a poor, poor pass by English. Here comes Shuey. Here is Follen, guarded by Frangelo. Here's Neri once again calling for the ball. Charlotte on her, and really good defense by Charlotte Levinson. Hands up, not letting her get that shot up.
Yeah, finally forcing like a good shot contest. Like, we've seen too many easy shots for Neri so far in this game. Like, she almost has 30 points. Like, now you're finally creating some hard shots.
As Ella Bushy comes in for Claire English. Now we have the starting five, I believe, for Emerson on the floor.
Yep, just a quick pause and play as the ball got wet a little bit.
Shuey to inbound. Passes it to Neri, who gets one step on her defender and gonna sink it right over Levinson. 31 points for Brianna Neri, and she just keeps going.
She's the game plan. If they're playing through her, they're playing whoever offense.
Asave starting to pull ahead, now leaving by 9, puts up a 3, and that's going to be no good from Kendra Dodd. A little bit of a contest there, maybe not the smartest shot.
She's on fire today. You live with that shot, you die with that shot, I think.
I think that's a good point. And that's going to be another travel for Salve Regina. That's Brianna Neri's second of the half. Really, I don't know what to say. This is the fifth travel called on them. And we hear Coach Hughes emphasizing the need to keep to not have silly turnovers like that.
Yeah, I think it's important. Like,
ooh. As Bree Frangelo finishes with emphasis at the rim.
That was a nasty layup. Just really just slithered through the defense and got to that layup.
And that's going to be an and one for Brianna Neri. She cannot be stopped today. Looking for points, 34. Brianna Neri, I mean, they can't stop her.
They can't.
And even when they're not stopping, they're fouling her and she still scores. Like, they need to game plan against this, and it just seems like whatever they're trying isn't working.
Yeah, sometimes you got to shock up the game plan and just, you know, and just say, like, we're going to stop you at all costs. We're going to double you, triple you, and not let you score.
And the other issue about Neri is she's just not missing the free throws.
Exactly. She is their offense right now.
As Bushy takes the ball with her left hand, and that's going to be a foul on the floor. Foul was on Ashley Rourke. Inbounded by Dodd to Frangelo. Frangelo guarded by Follen with space. Out to Delorier on the corner. Back to Bushy. Bushy looking, drives in, and will get the layup, getting by two defenders for a really strong finish at the rim.
Yep, really able to dissect through the lane and get that layup.
Good defense there by Kendra Dodd. On Shuey, able to force the turnover.
I think that was a travel. I'm not sure what the call was from the ref, but it was offensive.
It was an offensive foul.
Yep.
Offensive foul there. As Frangelo drives in with her right hand and gets it past the defender, falling to the floor. What can you say about Bree Frangelo? The 5'3 height does not matter.
Yeah, very much. If, you know, some people have watched, like, Caitlin Clark or Steph Curry, the way that they get to the lane and they just scoop it up, very, very similar to how Breeze gets to her.
As Frangelo comes down again, drives in, passes it looking for Bushy and doesn't get it. And back on that defensive play, Kendra Dodd with another really good contest. I think she's been great offensively, but really, really has had a good defensive impact in this game.
Yeah, I agree. She's a defensive stopper. She's really making her presence known on the defensive end of the ball today.
As she subs out for Salty. Getting a little bit of rest, much needed rest. Shui to Follin. Out to the corner. There is, and that is going to be a turn. No, Salve retains possession as Olivia Martin lost it for a second. Emerson trailing by 6 points with just under 2 minutes left, and that's going to be a terrible pass. Not a terrible pass, but a missed pass by Shui to Neri.
Yeah, the ball almost went to us right there.
Yeah, heads up. As this will be inbounded by Levinson.
I think I would have shot it if I got it. Not gonna lie.
I'd love to see it happen. And I think Emerson's gotta manage their time wisely at the end of this half and try to pull in a little bit closer.
Yeah, they need to start scoring.
As Salty's on the perimeter, passes it to Delorier. Back to Salty. To Bushy, wide open from three. And not able to make contact with the rim. Here is Follin.
Emil's wide open. You gotta hit those.
Out to Sofia Neri. Inside and stolen by Levinson. Her third steal of the half, I believe. Passes it to Delorier. And that's gonna be a bad pass by Delorier. Really sloppy off of Levinson. Back to Delorier. Here's Ferrangelo to the wing. Bushy drives in. Out to Salty. And they're going to reset. Really chaotic sequence of events right there. Yes. As Salty passes it in, Levinson backs down her defender. Out to Delorier, wide open. And not able to sink the open three.
Yeah, so far in the second half, they haven't been making the three-pointers. It really started since the second quarter. They haven't been making their three-pointers. They're taking the correct shots, but they're just not going in right now.
Yeah, back-to-back open misses for Emerson. First on Bushy, now on Delorier. It's expected that they'd decrease their percentages a bit from that hot start, but you gotta would like to see them bounce back.
Yes.
Really good tight defense there by Ava Salty on Shuli. There's Follin looking up, gets past Frangelo, and Frangelo will be called on the foul. Shows some frustration with herself.
Yeah, she kind of just stopped and defended off. Offensive player just went right by. And at that point, she reached, and that's a good foul right there.
Now, two shots here for Amanda Follin, the senior out of Attleboro, Massachusetts. And she will miss her first shot. Played 26 games in her junior year. Very good contributor to this team.
Down by seven. Emerson's only down by seven, half playing a very poor half.
Yeah,
they're still in this game.
Yeah, very good point right there. Here's Levinson with 30 seconds left in the half. In the quarter. Out to Bushy. Goes in with the right hand and finish. Bushy finishing at the rim once again this game, which she's been doing all night.
All season, to be honest. Like, she's really played to her game, played to her strengths, and that's what you like to see.
Up to 10 points for Ella Bushy with 14 seconds left in this quarter. Emerson 62, Salve 67. Here is Shui with the ball, getting a screen from Neri, and good hands there by Levinson. Neri gets 4 seconds left, out to Follin, looking for options, puts up the shot at the buzzer and puts it in with the layup at the buzzer. Amanda Follin with a really nice shot.
That's a good shot right there at the buzzer. As soon as there's a little bit of momentum going Emerson's way, Salve just completely shuts that down and gets a clutch in the rim.
Yeah, it looked like Emerson was getting close there at the end of the quarter, and now they're back to a 7-point deficit. Obviously not out of hand, but we're going to need some tight play from Emerson and a little bit of sloppy play from Salve, like what was happening earlier in the game.
Yes, and Emerson's going to start need to make their shots. Like, at the end of the day, you got to hit the shots to be in a close game. And if they don't make the shots, they're not going to win this game. I think that's the main thing. They got to get shots, and they got to stop Brianna Neri.
Yeah, absolutely. So far in this game, Sally Regina does have the advantage on the field goal percentage at 53 to Emerson's 49. And in terms of three-point percentage, Sally Regina shooting at 50%, Emerson shooting at 35%. So Emerson's shooting more at their regular rate. Sally's shooting with a bit of luck.
Yeah, I mean, in the first quarter, Emerson started off 5-7, and ever since then, they've only hit about probably like two threes, like actually one three.
And it's also very notable, Emerson getting out-rebounded by 8. I think the size advantage for Salve has been very visible tonight.
Yeah, it's a little bit too much to handle for Emerson. They're going to have to find a way to get some points and cut this deficit. They haven't been on the lead for much, but if they can get some stops, get some scores, this game will be a close, and it's going to be a great finish for us tonight.
Yeah, exciting. Get ready, everyone watching back home. This is going to be an exciting finish. As here, I will give it to Briggs once again for some information from the sideline. Briggs, what do you have?
Thank you so much. You know, Coach Gould is talking to his team about being more active on defense. He wants to see active feet, active hands. They want to scramble around the court to be active on defense. Now, we're going to see how that comes into play here in the last 10 minutes of the game as the Emerson Lions are down 7 points. Rico, back to you.
Thank you once again from Briggs Loveland with a great sideline reporting all night. As Emerson will inbound, here is Levinson, and it looks like she'll be passing to Frangelo. Frangelo out to Salty, thought about shooting for a moment. Levinson backs down, Neri gets past her. Out to Frangelo, wide open from three, and that is gonna be good from three.
Buckets.
Once again from three, Frangelo. Ice in her veins.
And she puts three to the sky, and then there's a...
As the PA announcer having a little fun with it.
She puts a three to the sky, and you know it's swish. That shit was swish right there.
That might have been the first time I've seen Bree Frangelo smile in this entire game.
Yep.
As that's going to be a shot that bounces out for Olivia Martin. No good on the three-pointer. Here comes Levinson, driving in hard to Frangelo, back again. Puts it up, heat check, and that's going to bounce out off the back rim.
Good shot right there.
Yeah, I like Frangelo taking those shots. She's the best shooter on this team. Why not?
It's the utmost confidence. She has a lot of confidence in herself and her ability to play basketball.
Follin able to get out of the double team, and that's going to be an errant pass by Follin. And Emerson has an opportunity to break closer and closer, now down only by 4 points.
Yep, you can see the energy is changing the building. Like, it's getting a lot more up-tempo, and it looks like the Salve coach is starting to get a little bit more hands-on with the team.
Yeah, good turnout here in the Stephen Plofstroy gym tonight. Here's Salty. And Bushy's going to be called for the travel.
That's an iffy call right there. She was, I don't know about that one. She was doing a jab step. I don't know if that's a travel, but that's up to the refs. They make the calls, I don't.
To be fair, it has been going that way all night. The travel has been called very, very strictly, so I think very that is strictly. A fair call. As here comes Rourke. Passing it inside to Martin, and there's Follin blocked by Levinson with the amazing block, using her size to just say no thank you,
no
not in this house.
You. Dikembe Mutombo, no thank you. Very much a good defensive play right there, getting all the stops that they need.
Levinson having a huge impact, as we said she would, defensively today. Here is Rourke asking for help, passes it to Shuey. Shuey calling a play. Defended by Dodd. Here comes a screen. Switches on to Levinson. Levinson back to Neri. Inside is Neri. Defended by Levinson and gets it in once again. As good as Levinson's been, she can't stop Neri. Neri now at 36 points.
Yeah, she didn't want to foul right there. That's why she only went hands up.
And Ella Bushy with a really nice layup. The contest has been not too much for Neri or Bushy tonight.
Yes, very much so.
As Neri sinks it from three, what can you say? She's been in a force inside, and the first shot she takes from three, she sinks.
That was a deep two, not a three right there.
Oh.
Deep two.
Apologies. You have a better sight than me, but still, what a shot by Neri.
What a shot. Yeah, she's been able to. Now she can take out the perimeter. That makes her hard to stop.
And Shuey receives the pass and puts it in for two. Salve Regina back to an 8-point lead.
Just like I said, every time a little bit of momentum swings Emerson away, Salve just stops it, completely ends it, and goes on a run of their own.
Really nice pass there by Levinson to Bushy, who puts it in once again for two more points.
That's a very good layup right there from Bushy. The angle was not in her favor, and she was still able to make it.
Levinson, not a shooter, but a great passer, great defender, and great force inside.
Yep.
Here's Dodd with the defense. Here's Shuey, guarded by Salty. Here is Neri. Passes it inside. There is Morgan. And not able to put it in was Olivia Martin. Excuse me. Here is Ava Salty. Bushy inside Levinson, wide open, and a really nice feed. First it was Levinson to Bushy. Now it's Bushy getting her back. Emerson down by 4. 6 minutes left in this game. 75 Salve, 71 Emerson. Here's Folan.
Miss Hughes is screaming on defense.
As Shuey drains one from 3. Guarded well by Salty. And I don't really know what to say. Their shots just keep falling.
Bang right there. That was a great 3 right there. Not much you can do about that. Hand down, man down, you know?
Emphatic might be the dagger. Here's Frangelo. Drops her defender. Here is Bushy and finishes with the foul at the... Oh, excuse me. That's going to be an offensive foul on Bushy. And Emerson seems extremely upset by that call.
I don't think she was set. We have to see a replay of that, but I don't think she was set.
Yeah, that's really iffy, especially since Frangelo got the defender on the floor. It would have been a beautiful play.
It would have been a beautiful play. That's a game-changing play right there.
That's a big blow for Emerson and a real momentum stopper as Ella Bushy comes out for Arnold. More specifically, Taylor Arnold.
The ref was trying to explain why it was a charge. I don't think he gave a great explanation to Bushy right there.
Shuey. Here's Rourke. Guarded really well by Dodd. Here's Neri. And that's going to be a foul on the floor. That's Ava Salty being called for the foul. Here's a view of the last foul on instant replay.
I mean, I must have been wrong. That is a good call. I don't know if she was in the lane or not, but
as Shuey shoots from 3 but does not bank it in.
It's a hard play to call. And good job on the ref for making that call.
Emerson down by 7 with 5.5 minutes left. Here's Salty. Back to Levinson. Dodd inside. And that's going to be a foul. A travel called on Kendra Dodd.
She took 2 steps without dribbling the ball. She was going into contact and she didn't think about dribbling.
Shuey handling the ball. I don't even think Shuey's been off the floor for a single second this game. No. Really shows her leadership and poise.
Yeah, she's, you know, every team needs a good point guard. It's important.
Shuey gets past the Salty, puts it up. Really nice move there by Morgan Shuey, the 5th-year player. Little frustration on the Emerson faces. Here's Frangelo, got to make something happen. Out to Dodd.
It's time to make something happen. You got to do it fast.
Arnold, back to Frangelo, puts it up. And bangs it once again. Bree Frangelo, amazing from deep tonight.
Yeah, she's locked in right now. I don't know what else to say, but she's locked in right now. 32 points on the night, she's locked in right now.
And carrying this team on her back, willing them back, trying to get closer to Salve's now 6-point lead, as that's a 3-pointer. No good by Folan and rebounded by Frangelo. Things can get interesting here. Here's Dodd. Looks up. Passes it inside. She's got Levinson. Levinson open. And that's going to be a no foul called. And a foul on the floor called on Salve Regina. Looked like initial contact wasn't called, and then it was called on the second contact.
Yes.
But Emerson has a chance here to bring it back to either a 4-point game or even a 3-point game.
And it looks like there's going to be free throws. Yes.
Yes. Seems as though Salve is in the bonus. Oh, actually a shooting shot. Shooting foul. First one goes in for Levinson.
Yeah, on the first one, she was definitely going into a shooting motion, but I don't know about the second one.
I don't either. It did look like it was a foul on the floor, but Emerson gets the lucky call there. And here's Frangelo out to Dodd, fakes the shot, gets her defender, pulls up from mid-range, not able to get it. Rebounded by Arnold, passes it out to Salty. Salty looking for options, drives in and gonna turn, gets her own miss dribble. Back to Frangelo, pulls up from three, and that's gonna be good!
Bree Frangelo able to sink it once again for Emerson. Unbelievable shooting from the 5'3" sophomore.
And they need a timeout, they need a timeout. That's another basket, another three. Three after three after three for Bree. Making plays in any sort of way she can.
Bree Frangelo is clutch. I don't care what you say. She is willing this team back in this game. They are down by 2 points with 4 minutes left. It was just a 9-point game, I believe.
Yes. She's just keeping it. It's gonna be a close one. It's gonna be a very fun one for us to watch these last 4 minutes. It's getting close. We're gonna see. And honestly, you gotta play through your best players. You gotta play through Neri, and you gotta play through Fangulo. If you don't, I think that's what you gotta do right now.
And Salve can't be giving Bree that much space.
No, they gotta contest her hard.
They've gotta be pressing her at the 3-point line a little bit more.
I think, you know, if I was them, I would pick her up at half.
Here is Rourke, guarded by Dodd. Back to Shuey, guarded by Salty. Back to Rourke, inside. That's Neri, puts it up and doesn't make it. Seems like a rare occurrence tonight. Really nice behind the move back there by Frangelo. Frangelo out to Salty, wide open from three. And that's going to be very short for Ava Salty.
Damn, that could have been a huge three, but then go in.
Frangelo gets beat a little bit, recovers. Here is Rourke with the ball. And that's going to be a nice steal by Levinson. Really good defense. Here's Frangelo coming down and puts the layup in and ties this game up. We are tied at 80 apiece, ladies and gentlemen.
Yep, Bree just skipped through that lead. Filet. That's a nice little lay right there for Bree.
Unbelievable play by Bree Frangelo. Now at 37 points for Bree Frangelo.
And that's a three from Salve just to get by.
Bree Frangelo with her season and I believe career high in this game. Unbelievable play by the sophomore transfer from Bryant University, showing why she was a D1 player. Here's Dodd from three, not able to get it in, and this is going to be Salve possession.
As you see, it's Bree's season high in points. As I said, she's a bucket. She's an absolute bucket getter. She's gonna get to her spots, get to the lane, shoot the three. She does everything really well.
And we are having an incredible game because we have two players who are over 36 points.
It's insane.
And there's 2 minutes left. And Arnold in with a hand on the defense. Folan gets the rebound. 5 seconds left. Passes it in to Neri. Will she get the shot up? She does, and no good. That was Sophia Neri with the missed shot. Here comes Bree Frangelo on the fast break. Frangelo looking, has space. Decides not to shoot. Gives it to Levinson. Out to Dodd, 4-3. Not able to sink it. Rebounded by Arnold and put in by Arnold with the clutch rebound and finish. Taylor Arnold, the freshman, putting in her work.
Emerson does not seem that they want to go away from losing this game.
A relentless effort by the team as Shuey gets past Salty, and that's going to be a foul on the floor.
Yep, Salty with the just slap on the hip as the Salve offensive player was just going up for a layup.
And something to look at, number five, Sophia Neri in a bit of foul trouble. So maybe not able to play that much inside. Guarded by Arnold inside. Here is Salve. That looked like a step back pass to Folan. And that's going to be a turnover and a great steal by Bree Frangelo, leading the team down the court, one against two, and she'll reset. Didn't like her numbers. Here comes Levinson. Levinson driving in with the left hand, puts it up and sinks it in using all of her height to put that ball in the bottom of the net.
It's getting close. That's an important basket right there for Emerson.
Charlotte Levinson standing at 6 feet tall, and Emerson is playing amazingly.
And that's another timeout. This is going to end very interesting. Rico, what are we going to do last minute?
I don't know. This is crazy. Emerson leading 84 to 83. We have a 1-point lead here. I think this game is going to come down to the wire, and I think, I don't want to jinx it, but I think we're going to have a really exciting finish.
I think so, too. I think these next possessions are just going to go Bree, Neri, Bree, Neri. We'll see which star player is going to be able to will their team to the finish.
Yeah, sort of how we see in the professional leagues all the time. It comes down to your star player, 1v1, to end of the game. They're so close to hitting that 40-point mark. I think they're going to do it.
I think they're going to do it as well. It's been a great game so far, and we're just getting ready for an incredible finish here with ECS.
As the buzzer beats and the teams will come back in. And now I will give it back to Briggs Loveland for some more sideline reporting.
Hey, thanks again, Rico. Assistant coach DiCecco told the team on offense, hey, push the ball, push the tempo, get them to foul, get them to make contact so they can get to the free throw line. On the defensive side, help everywhere. Try to help everyone on screens, whether it's a double team, et cetera, et cetera. They need help defensively. Hopefully, Emerson can pull out a win, Rico.
Thanks, Briggs. Inbounding is Neri. 1 minute left in this contest. Gives it to Rourke. Rourke with the ball. Hand in by Salty. Here is Neri. Back to Neri. Follin. Neri. Brianna Neri out to Shuey. Shuey calling a play. Calls for the screen from Neri. Gets it. Gets a switch. Mismatch. Out to the wing. 4-3. And bangs it. Rourke with the dagger three with 40 seconds left in the game. Here comes Bree Frangelo and the Emerson Lions team. This is getting really interesting, ladies and gentlemen. Here's Frangelo with the ball. Passes it to Arnold. Back to Salty. Levinson. Emerson trails by two. Here's Frangelo looking for options. Gets it into Levinson. Puts it up and not blocked by the backboard. Really poor shot there by Levinson. And 18 seconds left. Emerson has to foul, and they will foul Rourke. What a shot. What a crucial shot. It is such a crucial moment by Ashley Rourke.
That was a contested three, and it came from someone we didn't expect. We thought it was going to come from Neri or someone else.
Or Martin, yeah.
It just didn't happen, you know.
And Rourke, a 32% three-point shooter on the season, makes it in the biggest possible moment.
Yeah, that was a big shot. Big-time players make big-time plays. I don't think I need to say it any louder than that. That was an insane shot. It was contested, too. It wasn't even like the shot was wide open. It was a hard shot to make. So, big-time players.
As Emerson, I think you've got to live with that shot. You can't really beat yourself up for it because you did get the contest. You're only down by two. Give it to your best player, Bree Frangelo, right now, and let her cook.
Well, first, the biggest thing is we need a foul, and we got to hope for a free throw to miss. If a free throw doesn't miss, it's going to be a four-point game, and it looks like it might be a little bit out of reach. But we got a foul. Hope for a miss, and then you got to give it to Bree and let her cook. And like everyone say, like Rico said.
Yeah, as we look forward to the next stream, we'll be on Saturday at 12 p.m. on January 27th. It is a men's volleyball versus Fisher College, and we look forward to seeing you there. Definitely a very exciting game as the men open their season at home against Fisher. Thank you. Here comes the Emerson squad. We have Levinson, Bushy, Frangelo, Delorier, and Dodd. Looking to foul really quickly as Emerson needs to get back in this game, and they foul. They foul Rourke. Intentionally giving it to Rourke as she is a very good free throw shooter, 84% on the season.
Yeah, they're shooting 81% today as a team, so there's a slim chance that she might give up one, but it is a crucial time, and you don't know these players could fold under pressure.
It's very true. And the first one rattles in. This is the key one right here. If she makes this, it's going to be tough for Emerson to bounce back. Emerson fans making a bit of noise, trying to distract her. Rourke with the shot, able to sink it despite the noise from the crowd. And Emerson now trails by four. Still not out of the game. What does Emerson need to do to give themselves a chance?
So, you know, you could take a two, but I think personally, like, I'm going to take the three right here. You gotta make her, it's a make or break shot. You gotta take the three, and if it misses, it misses. You gotta give it to Bree, high screen and roll. That's what I would do.
Yeah, maybe something with Levinson and Bree. Levinson on the pick and roll, or Bushy potentially inside. I think you gotta score quick and try to get them back to the line, try to force an error. If that three does open up, maybe for Dodd, maybe for Frangelo, those are the two I'd be the most comfortable taking it. Possibly Delorier as well, who's shot well today.
You have to live with the percentages. Like, Dodd is playing great from the three-point line. If she shoots it, you gotta let her take it. If Bree shoots it, you gotta let her take it. I think the most important thing is to take the three, and then you foul again, and you may have to make another three.
It's going to be the same squad on the floor for Salve Regina, and I believe it is the same squad on the floor for Emerson, as it is Levinson, Frangelo, Dodd, Delorier, and Bushy.
Looks like Miss Hughes, the Salve coach, is preaching defend without fouling.
Levinson will inbound with 14 seconds left in this game. Long pass to Bushy. She's open. Not looking for it. Frangelo from three. Bang! She sinks it from three. Bree Frangelo with the emphatic shot. Unbelievable. Unstoppable. What else can you say about this player?
Bucket getter. Ice in her veins. Ice in her veins. That's an absolute bucket. Off the screen. Able to take the three. Bang.
Bree Frangelo, 10 seconds left in this game, sinks the three. I don't know how they're letting her be open like that. But at the end of the day, it's not easy to make that shot, and she does it every single time.
Exactly. She practices that shot. That's a shot she wants to take, and the coach trusts her to take that shot every single time.
With that quick release, it's so hard to get a contest. And here, we'll send you to replay as we'll show you that amazing three-point shot by Bree Frangelo.
So as you see, there was not even a screen. The defender slipped, and it was just a wide-open three for Bree.
Just sound on that shot. Now Salve, two inbound. Emerson trailing by one, but if they're able to get the foul back, they're back into the game, no matter what. Emerson will probably try to avoid the inbound going to either Rourke or... Yeah, really, Rourke is their best shooter from the free throw line. Followed by Follin, and Neri's been good from the line as well today.
Brianna Mary has probably missed a few free throws today, not that many. So, she's 10 for 11 from the line. Only missed one. You can't foul her, you know. You might have to foul Martin, miss the one, and Follin miss one.
I'd like to give the ball to Neri as it might be easier as she's taller. But she is guarded by the 6 foot Levinson. We'll see. Inbounded by Shuey. Fouled immediately is Rourke once again. Rourke took a bit of hard contact there, but she made the last two under pressure. Let's see if she can do it again.
Let's see. These are the biggest free throws of the game right here, because you either make it a 2 point game or you make a 3 point game with a three needed.
As Bushy checks in for O'Mara, there are 9.5 seconds left in this game. Emerson fans sure to make a lot of noise right now behind, as the first one is good. True from Rourke, the junior forward out of Londonderry, New Hampshire. This is a very big shot here by Rourke. And she sinks it. Clutch shooting and timeout here by Emerson.
Yeah, four clutch free throws that went in back to back, basically.
Now things are going to get difficult for Emerson because they're expecting the three.
Yeah, so they're expecting the three. They're going to have to run a very solid play right here to get someone open. Honestly, I'm giving the ball to Bree again. Like, I don't think there's anyone else on the court that's going to make this, that's going to make it at a high clip that Bree does. I'm going to give it to her. Or I think Don has a good chance of making the three. Those are the best three-point shooters on the floor for this game. And I think those are two people I'd give the ball to in this one.
What would you think about Emerson trying to go for a really quick two and getting fouling again?
They could do that, but I don't know if that's the best situation right here.
As we see Bree sink that beautiful three-pointer once again with confidence and not much reaction from her.
Yeah, she does this. I don't think there's anything else to say. She does this.
Yeah, she doesn't even surprise herself. She's used to it.
That's ice bloody.
I'm not sure about dropping 40 points like she did. As she puts it up from three, and that's no good. And that's going to be rebounded by Salve Regina.
That was a great shot right there. You got to live and die with those.
You got to. She got the open shot, and the game is not over, but that is unfortunate for Emerson. Emerson is going to have to look to foul again, and there's some...
And it looks like there's some miscommunication between the ref and Miss Hughes, the Salve coach. It looks like she didn't want to call the timeout if they had missed the shot. But the ref still called the timeout anyways, which is not really a good situation here. Makes it really hard because now there's a good chance that they have to advance the ball.
Yeah, and inbounding can be difficult. They do have a size advantage. We'll see what ends up being a result of this. But Salve Regina leading 90 to Emerson 87 with 5 seconds left in this game. Brie Frangelo not able to literally do everything with one very rare miss right there. But I think no matter what happens today, this game just shows you the leadership and the type of player that Brie Frangelo is.
Yeah, it shows that she's a star here for the NUMAC.
O'Mara guarding the inbound, and that's going to be foul immediately by Delorier. A little bit hard. That's Rourke again, who's made the last 4 free throws for Salve Regina.
Yeah, she's really iced this game, basically.
Emerson hoping for her to miss both here. Very unlikely, as we noted, she is an 84% free throw shooter on the season. As the first one goes in. And that's going to make it really difficult for Emerson to get back in this game as they now trail by 4 points.
Yeah, basically impossible, especially if this one goes in.
And the second one rims in.
6.
Emerson down by 5. Passes it to Frangelo. She's driving up the court with speed. Chucks it up from half court. No good. And Salve Regina will win this game 92 to Emerson 87. Tough end there for Emerson. It looked like they were going to be back in the game, just not able to capitalize on those last chances.
Yeah, Rourke with the 6 clutch free throws basically iced this game by herself. She put the team on her back, made all those free throws, and ended the game right there.
Yeah, I think all the credit at the end of that game goes to Rourke. As you said, she completely just took it under control. She didn't let any of the crowd noise, which as a college athlete, when they're right in front of you, can be difficult.
Yeah, you know, the Emerson Lion fans were going crazy. They're trying to make him stop, but ice in her veins. She said, I'm gonna make these free throws. She made all those free throws, ended the game. But also, we gotta show a huge shout out to the performance from Brianna Neary. A complete performance from the inside. Was able to score at will and do everything that she wanted to do, basically.
Yeah, I mean, Brianna Neary was unstoppable tonight. She was shooting 63% from the field goal line and had 38 points. Shot 10 of 11 from free throw at a 90% clip. She was unstoppable and only had 2 fewer points than Frangelo. She was unbelievable and the leader of this team.
Yeah, very much so. And on the Emerson side, it was another great game from Brie. Like, she does this. I know there's not much to say at this point. If you watch the streams, you know everything that happens and how great of a basketball player she is.
And with Kendra Dodd, I think as a freshman, she's truly established that she can shoot the 3 ball. She can shoot the hell out of it. And I think they're going to maybe start to use her a little bit more.
Yeah, I agree. I think something that's going to be needed to be used in the future.
For Emerson, they now move to 2-2 within the conference. Salve Regina moving to a record of 3-1, which is very good for them.
Yeah. Thank you, everybody, for watching.
Our next game will be, on January 27th, the men's volleyball team versus Fisher College, their opening home game for the men's volleyball team. Make sure to check in for that one. It's going to be a great game. And, yeah, I think it was an incredible performance by these two teams. As a basketball fan, as a fan of the sport, it was a treat to watch. And from Emerson Channel Sports, we thank you. I'm Rico Brill.
I'm Godfrey Simpri.
And thank you for tuning in. We'll be back.